Okay. So a couple of videos back, I said I had one more of these. And we were going to polish it using this nondescript kind of scrub polish that's good for glass and stone countertops. Take this one apart. We do. Ooh. Start. I also got this little scrubby dab here. Let's give it a little schmoo. See if we can utilize this to do anything. This particular scrubby dub is designed for nonstick pans and such, so it doesn't. Hopefully won't scratch up off the plating too much or at all. We're looking for no scratching off of the plating, just the awfulness on the plating. That, I mean, I'm surprised. It's not the best of results. Let's need a little more in here. I made that noise with my mouth. May after this is all said and done, I'll hit it with a polish wad. polish wad, just kind of shine it up a little bit. But really, we're just looking to see if it'll take much of this patina off. I wonder what they put in here. Like it kind of, it's got a little bit of that something hot or something, who knows. It's kind of got a, what looks like a anodization, but it's really just more yuck. Okay. Actually, come and look. It's not half bad. I mean, it's not half great, but. Get in there with this thing. Okay, so, I will be right back in just a moment. We're gonna wash this off and see what it looks like. Okay. Check it out. What is that? It's a weird dark spot in the plating. Or a light spot. Anyways, actually that worked not too shabby-like. I think I'm gonna go over it with the wadding subvertly. And then we'll compare it. Actually, let's compare it right now to the other one. So here. Another one. Actually pretty comparable. This one's just a tad more cleaner. I think it's just because we kind of got into it with it. And this one had a harder time getting really in the nooks and crannies and kind of penetrating with the polish soap, I suppose it's called. I don't know. Just says not to put it in the eyes. Don't put it in the eyes. I mean, what are you supposed to put in your eyes then? Okay, so I'm gonna give this a quick rub down, and we'll come back to it, see if we can make it any more pretty. So as before. Just a little chunk of this wadding here, and we'll go to town on it. Be right back. All right, we gave it a little rub down with the wadding. Just kind of use this old t-shirt here. A little bit better. I mean, beggars can't be choosers, I guess. Just a couple of bucks from a thrift store down the road. I forgot to get the inside. Well, put it back together. I didn't really cover that. It's got this little notch here and here, which I kind of like. It takes a little bit of the guesswork out, so you're not trying to struggle to line it up. Your little zinc-plated screw in there and line it up with the grooves that they have inside. Take your nondescript Phillips head screwdriver through. A little oily still. Make sure for grip. Make sure it's good in hand. Tight. There you go. One is one. Two is one. Something like that. Something like that. Thanks for watching.